hear what others think, also to express your mind. So I, one by one, from this side, you raise your hand and take the opportunity. Now I call, I open the session for public discussion, and I call upon you, please. But be short. Put a question, rather.
Yeah. Thoughts, time should not be the constraint. Otherwise, we cannot think freely. You see, what he talked is great essence today, and it should be recorded. Its root cause is somewhere else. We are cutting the tree from the top. We are not removing the root cause of the terrorism.
Make your point.
My point is this, that we should make every nation to introspect and come forward with the realities where they are helping the terrorists by supplying arms and ammunition. They should come forward with a declaration, yes, we have stopped supplying arms and ammunition to the terrorists from today onwards. Good. This kind of thing must come from every country. Let it be China, let it be Pakistan, let it be America, let it be any other country. They must come forward on a round table conference where they should say and declare that we, from today onward, we will not supply any arms and ammunition to anybody. Then there will be no terrorism.
Good, thank you.
Anything?
Please.
No.
My viewpoint regarding the terrorism is...
I will appreciate if you give your name.
I am Shipwell.
Give your name.
Advocate Shipwell. My viewpoint is, until we stop doing politics over terrorism, we cannot remove terrorism at all. Before going ahead talking about international terrorism, we have to cut and remove terrorism from within ourselves. As you must have seen, even today, the great leader of Congress, Digvijay Singh, has made a statement that Thackeray was not shot by terrorists on 26/11 by the Pakistani terrorists. It was done by the Saffron terrorists. He got threats in the Malegaon investigation from the Saffron terrorists. That's why he was killed. So on the one side, we are advocating, we are taking the case, pleading the case with the United Nations, with the USA, with UK, so many other countries, to compel upon, to prevail upon the Pakistan that they should teach them a lesson, they should hold the person guilty. But on the other side, we ourselves are saying that this was not the act of those terrorists. So how we can think of that we can fight terrorism?
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Anybody else from that side? Please.
My point is, so far I think, that poverty is the main cause for terrorism. Let's take an example. The life history of Mr. Kassam, who is under prison. He is a very poor person. His father is a poor farmer, who had goats and sheep, but not possible. They fall in the trap. So long you won't be able to eradicate poverty, at the same time, retaliation. So it is our duty to make them educated. So it won't be possible from anywhere in the world to combat the terrorism. So eradicate terrorism, first focus point should be poverty, eradication of poverty, and to educate the Christians. Then 80% problem will be solved, so I think.
Thank you. Yes,
I
have to sum up the terrorism. Actually, the main cause of terrorism is poverty, difference of opinion, clashes of civilization. These are the main cause. Arms, there is no arms, the people will fight with the stones. They will fight something else to fight them. The main cause of terrorism is something different. That is, we have to look to those causes, that is the, in my mind, that is the poverty, the economic differences or social differences or ideological differences.
Thank you.
Sir, when the Home Minister of a state, when the Home Minister of Democratic State, when this person can be Home Minister of India, why can't this personal concern of the state can't be the Prime Minister or the President of India? In case we are particular for the Azadi, there was a very good views about Honorable Bhim Singh Ji. But the question is, till then, what should we do? Should we keep on working? The only criteria is, this way we have simplified our laws, they are to be restricted, as per the Honorable Major General Sahab has said. And simultaneously, we have to see, sir, Muslim fanaticism being manufactured and perpetrated from the cross of the border. They are such a persons. Why not about Jammu? Why not about other persons, about other parts of the state? Why only Srinagar? Again, I would like to repeat, their talk of Azadi, when a home minister, when a person of the state can be the home minister, they know that a person of the state can be prime minister also. He can be president of India also. Then where the question of Azadi, what more interpretation they have in respect to the concept of Azadi?
I got your point. Thank you very much. Anybody else? Yeah, kindly.
I'm sorry, I'm a late entrant. The terrorism, according to me, is because of lack of patriotism. The institution, the government institution, has not made efforts to ensure that patriotism is imbibed right from the childhood. For example, earlier we used to have, even in movies, when you complete the movie, at the end you used to have national anthem. That is taken away for whatever reason it is. And with due respects to the judiciary, the Honorable Supreme Court held that whenever a national anthem is sung, it is not necessary that you should expect it and sing it. If you simply silently felt it, it is fine. What does this indicate? We have to create, it is like something like this. A butterfly is coming out of an insect. But how? It is said that an insect...
I will give the...
I would request the Honorable President of International Council of Jurists to give away the mementos to the Honorable Speakers. Dr. R. K. Dixit.
Yes, sir.
Think that if it was so, then the terror attack, 9/11, and the problem between the two Irelands perhaps would not have been there, number one. Number two, to wish away that the armament industry would not exist. Well, armament industry is the biggest industry in the world, and I don't foresee any sign that manufacture of arms would come to an end. In fact, even under the United Nations Charter, they say that the war is legal for the act of self-defense. And so I've covered the point with regard to poverty, with regard to the arms, and also there are a number of causes, as Mr. Dutt has said, with his long experience with the Indian Police Service. And here it is a person no less than Mr. Dutt who carried out the operations in Bombay, saying that to wish that terrorism will sort of be totally eradicated may not come about. At best, we may be able to contain it. And lastly, with regard to no single definition of terrorism, well, in law there is no definition of terrorism, that's quite correct. But at the same time, our law, I would like to say, is very clear as to what all constitute a terrorist act. So therefore, without getting into the semantics as to what is terrorism, we are very clear as to what is a terrorist attack. Thank you, sir.
Sir, there's one point. Sir, political lacunas within the law itself, the waiting to its implementation, effective implementation. So would you say, would you opinion, it should be materialized or it should be withdrawn?
Well, I would
like in discussion only.
No solution.
Work out.
You can't tear some device.
You're right. There's no
concern. You only ask some questions.
Officer of British Telecom, he was earlier worked as principal advisor in TRAI, Telecom Regulatory Authority. Mr. H.G. Saxena has worked earlier as director of finance of BSNL and now chairman of his association called PTCIF. I myself, N.K. Goyal, I represent several of telecom associations. One of them is CMAI, Communications, Multimedia and Infrastructure. Another is Telecom Equipment Manufacturers. I'm the chairman of Telecom Equipment, President CMAI. Mr. Saxena is vice chairman of the association. Mr. Gupta is director. And I'm in telecom sector for the last 40 years. On my left, Mr. Yogesh Kochar. He's director of Microsoft India in the sector for so many years, and he brings with us the experience of MNC, and he's also the director of CMAI. I think I will change the format. Earlier we thought we'll do the presentations, etc., but let us convert it into type of discussions across one to one. I'm sure you all know in the legal profession that telecom perhaps is one of the most litigant sector right from day one when it started. We started long back in telecom when we had some laws made by UK for SIPs for communications. Then down the line we have a Indian Telegraph Act of 1885. Still we are going in the same act. Wherever we go in the world, there is litigation right from day one when we think of telecom. Whether it is spectrum, whether it is licensing, whether it is tariff, whether it is security issues, whether it is technology issues, whether it is CDMA versus GSM, spectrum to be auctioned or not to be auctioned, licenses to be given free or with some restrictions. And of late, security issues have, I think, become more and more relevant to all of you know. I think with this brief introduction, I will request Mr. Gupta a few minutes each, and then we'll take questions from him. That will be, I think, can add some more value.
Thank you, Goyal Sahab. Good evening, everyone. It's indeed a great pleasure to be here.